Hey, are you ready for some fun?
You know, we've got just the thing. It's Mike and Maddie's Motown reunion celebration.
Do yourselves a favor. Move the coffee table. Get ready to dance. Motown's on its way.
The Temptations, Mary Wilson from the Supremes, Martha Reeves, and more. Coming up next on Mike and Maddie. It's Mike and Maddie's Motown reunion celebration, and you're invited. So stop in the name of fun, because here come your hosts, Michael Berger and Maddie Monfort.
All right. Welcome. Now, hold on. I wanted to introduce Maddie. Specifically, I wanted her to have her own moment here, because I ran into her in the hall. I have never seen Motown personified more. From head to toe, the girl is Motown. Maddie Monfort!
Hi, everybody. Thank you.
Isn't this great?
Welcome to the 60s!
I hope I didn't offend Maddie, because I ran into her in the hall and I said, oh, Jane Jetson. You know, because
the whole... Actually, we got the whole little silver boot look. But I'll tell you, I dressed like this for this Motown celebration, but you're going to be seeing more of this look this fall. This is what's in.
This is it.
Maud. You're going to be seeing all of... Not Maud from the show.
No.
The Maud look.
The whole show today celebrates the music, the good times, the feel. And even our set today is decorated as such.
Does this not look great? Look at this place.
What you don't know.
We have got the best staff in the world.
We didn't want to tell you this before we got on the air because we didn't want you to panic, but there is a $4 two-drink minimum. Today,
no,
we have with us
though.
The Temptations are from the Supremes, Mary Wilson.
Would have been born in the heyday of Motown, and actually, I was in 1965.
You were like this.
And you know, and no matter what age you are, you know, when you hear the Motown sound, it just makes you want to get up and move, right? But when the Motown sound was created, you know, in the 60s, it truly was a musical revolution. Take a look.
Hitsville, USA, the home of the Motown sound. It literally changed the way the world hears music. With hits like Heat Wave and Dancing in the Streets, Martha Reeves and the Vandellas created an anthem for young America. A sound that still calls us to our feet decades later. Then there was America's answer to the Beatles, the ultra-glamorous Supremes. They became the biggest female pop group ever. After 12 number one hits and more than 60 million records sold, the Supremes were more than a sound, they were a symbol. And that talent that was born in Motown still reigns supreme today. But of course, there was more than just the music. There were also the moves. As pretty as you are. And no one quite moved like the Temptations. Known as the Emperors of Soul, they have sold over 22 million records and have had 43 top 10 singles. Over the past 35 years, they've changed faces and voices, but they've never missed a beat. And the Motown sound still goes on.
Great music all day, and we're going to deliver. Let's get started. The one, the only Motown legend, Mary Wilson! Woo! Woo!
Hey! Generous love. Hello! I'm in an old, cold, run-down tenement slum. And my father left, he never even married mom, and I shared the guilt my mama knew. So afraid that others knew I had no name. Oh, the luck we're contemplating, it's worth the pain of waiting. Are we lonely in the patient? The child we made, we made a little love child. Woo! Never meant to be.
Sexy Supreme.
Take a break. We'll be right back.
Still ahead, the legendary Temptations bare their souls and perform live right here. Number 3 in all-time hits, right behind Elvis and the Beatles.
Celebration continues, and joining us, Mary Wilson, you have caught your breath, have you?
Yes. And may we just say, both of us were admiring you, and the whole staff is just in awe of how gorgeous she is.
Oh,
is she not looking wonderful? Really?
Music keeps you young, huh?
Well, you know, I don't know if it's music, but I think what I find is that enjoying what you do. Yeah. You know, I love performing. I really do.
Tell me how it happened, that moment when you were discovered, you know, your lucky break, because you came from a time when
We were not discovered, though.
What would you call it?
Well, we weren't discovered. We actually formed ourselves, and we went after Motown to sign us.
Really?
So it's a little different than being discovered.
Didn't you used to hang out at the offices?
Yes, we had to make them sign us.
What did you do? How did that happen?
Well, because we went there for an audition, and we were called the Primettes. Mr. Gordy, we were about 16 years old. Mr. Gordy said, "Oh, you know, you're too young. Come back when you graduate from high school." Well, we didn't do that. We came back every day after school, and we just sat on the outside, and then pretty soon we were inside the lobby. Pretty soon we were inside his office, and pretty soon he signed us.
He just keeps sneaking a little closer,
Little by little, he got there.
Yeah. So we made them discover us. Let's put it that way.
Wow, fun.
And this has been such a total shock for you girls. I mean, because you became so unbelievably popular, and you came from the projects.
From the Brewster Projects in Detroit, Michigan, right.
How did that change your life?
Well, you know what happened? One time we were performing in England. We were doing a command performance. And it was, I think, 1965. We were still living in the projects, but we were traveling all over the world. We were international stars, and we didn't have enough time to buy houses or whatever with all our new money, right?
So you're still living in the projects.
So we were still living in the projects. We did this command performance, and after the performance, Princess Margaret, Prince Charles, you know, the Queen Mother, everyone, you know, came by, and we said hello, and we had these gorgeous, gorgeous beaded gowns, and the Princess Margaret says, "Ooh, is that a wig you're wearing?" And I mean, I know you've heard this story before because I tell it all the time. I think it was the most magnificent story of all. Here we are still, you know, living in the projects, very, you know.
And here you are, hobnobbing with royalty.
Yeah, right. And she says this to me. And so the next day we were looking at all of our newspaper clippings in it, and there I was staring at the Queen Mother with this horrible look on my face like I could kill her. So that was a part of me that was still in the projects is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, don't mess with me, gal, is what you're saying, huh? Yeah. It's funny, you said that you gave up stardom to join the Supremes. Maybe I'm misquoting somewhat, but that's the gist of it, was it not?
No, I think maybe other people may feel that like that. I feel that when I joined the Supremes, when I met Florence and Diane and Betty, my life began. I mean, I met the other parts of me. And as far as I'm concerned, my career helped me become who I am. Mm-hmm. I think a lot of people feel they give up a part of their lives when they become stars, but I don't.
Did you worry about sharing the spotlight?
Me?
Yeah.
No, I really didn't. We all did in the earlier days, and when it was decided that we could not, that wasn't really important. What was important is that we made it, you know? And mm-hmm. that was what I went for. Whatever the group said was good, that's what I would say. Okay, let's do it.
Yeah.
How was your relationship with Diana now? I know you guys were estranged for a little while, and then now are you...
You know, everybody says that. You know, everyone says this story has gotten so far out of whatever. I think that both she and I have fallen into the trap of believing it, and then we both have done some things that perhaps maybe we should not have done to each other. But in my heart, you know, I love her because we share something that if you know, anybody would want to be a Supreme or a Temptation, you know, or for a top. And I think that I share something so beautiful with her.
Of course.
There's an essence of love there that I could never, ever do anything but love. So I'll always love her. And so my son passed away last year.
I know, I'm sorry.
And it's one of those things where his love, having had his love in my life, was so beautiful that it's still with me. So it's the same with Diane. That love that I love is still there. So nothing can destroy it. You know, me, her, or business.
Well,
or whatever.
Say it destroy you, that's interesting, because when a tragedy like that happens, how does that affect you on stage?
Well, for me, it was wonderful because I had that to go to.
Yeah.
I had something in my life to feel that void. My 17-year-old son said something that was so magnificent. He said, "Mom, it's like a big hole has been taken out of my chest." Mm-hmm. I'm like, "Oh, for 17, that was pretty profound, you know." Yeah. So I think it was like it was a big hole taken out of my soul. So, you know, therefore, I have to have something to feel that. Mm-hmm. And my music, my career, I think I've learned something from my son's death, and that is that life is very precious, and you got to enjoy it. So I thoroughly enjoy it now.
Yeah, I enjoy you.
You made so many people happy.
We're starting this album here. The Supremes and the Temptations build together on this album, and we thought it'd be appropriate to bring the team back together.
Oh.
One of the original Temptation. Is that the way you say that?
That's
he
right.
is the original
the
Temptation.
Original.
That sounds biblical, doesn't it? Yeah. How about Otis Williams? Come on out!
How you doing?
Oh. Can you imagine these people at like a family party? Can you imagine what their parties are like?
Well, how about in a car singing at a stoplight? Because you guys are traveling. You're on tour.
We're on tour, yes. In fact, we're working here tonight and tomorrow night at the Universal Amphitheater.
That's correct.
And
Motown
I gotta say,
tour.
I'm so happy because, you know, we did a lot of things together in the past. We used to travel on those Motown tours
Motown reviews, on those raggedy
buses.
Yeah. Well, compare the past, traveling in the 60s, with all that meant, traveling in the 60s, to traveling now, what's the difference?
Well, for us, it's a lot of change because we travel by two big buses.
Right.
Back during those days, it would be the Supreme, one bus. Yeah, musicians and roadies and everybody on one bus.
Yeah.
Now we
and
have
two. The bus was raggedy, too. The
very,
bus
raggedy.
Very raggedy.
And we only have one
nice
driver.
Bus
now, huh?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
VCR, you know, cooking, you know, the whole bit.
A lot of creature really comforts, beds, and what have you.
Yeah. It's really nice to be back with the Temptations. I mean, I've begged them and the Four Tops for years. Please let me go on tour with you. Let me go on tour with you. I have been a groupie. Of the Temptations and the Four Tops since I was a kid.
Now, that doesn't make you feel old.
Sure, I'm not old.
I'm still an old teenager. Oh, yeah, okay.
You're looking good.
Mary backstage was videotaping all you guys hanging out backstage, running around.
Yeah, that's right.
And it's truly a family, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, from day one. Like she was saying about the
Primates, we were together all the way back during that time. Mm-hmm. So it's been very interesting to watch the metamorphosis all the way up to now.
Of all of us. In fact, we were in high school together, all of
right.
us.
Right.
Really?
And Melvin and I used to be like, kind of like sweethearts.
Melvin's always had the hots for Mary.
Yeah.
Speaking of hots.
I think a lot of guys have had the hots for Mary. Look at this, she's a babe.
We will turn up the heat. Speaking of hot, next, the Temptations going to sing Maty's favorite song, My Girl. That's
yeah!
coming up next.
Get ready for some dancing in the studio when the ever phenomenal Martha Reeves heats up our show.
Well, our Mike and Maty Motown reunion continues. Make no mistake about it. After 35 years, they are still the emperors of soul. Get ready, because here they come, to borrow a phrase, the Temptations and My Girl! The members of your group here who worked so very hard for you.
To my right,
Theo Peoples. Hello.
Hey. Yeah.
To my left, Ron Tyson.
Yes.
And my extreme left, Ollie Woodson.
Yeah. Is it tough joining a group like this, since you weren't part of this group in the beginning? Is it tough joining a legendary group like this?
It's very tough, especially if you don't know how to dance.
You know, speaking of the dance, you guys have that famous Temptation walk.
Right.
Give us a little inkling on how you do that, because today I'm learning it.
Oh, well, come on, let's step on
this. Okay.
Now, it's really easy to do. It's going side,
This way, then yourself.
Yeah, give him a little rhythm behind it.
All right, I tell you what, let's get a little music. And
then there you go. There you go. Okay.
A little music.
I know Side by Side. I don't know anything else, but.
Mike and Maddie's Motown reunion celebration continues.
11:30. Motown reunion continues. You know, when we go to commercial, you know, you leave, but we don't. We stay and just have a party.
So,
having fun. Let me get everybody caught up tour-wise and what's out. Now, Otis, I know you have a new album out, right?
Yes, we have a new album coming out September the 26th.
Called?
It is called For Lovers Only.
Okay, I'll be at the record stores immediately.
And again, the Motown tour.
Pardon?
The tour that you're on?
Yes, it's with the Four Tops, Temptations, the Spinners, myself, Mary Wilson, other Supremes. And I want to make an announcement, too. Junior Walker was also on the show, and he's taken ill, so he won't be a part of the show tonight nor tomorrow. Right. So we're sending out
send our thoughts
prayers
to him.
Of course, bless his heart.
And I want to mention my new record, too.
I'm writing it down.
Okay.
What is it?
Okay, it's called You. You played the clip before we came.
Right, of course.
It's a new single, and it's nice, so I hope everybody likes
it. There you go. Oh, look at her.
On the show, we'll be doing all the, you know, the Motown records.
All the
right.
favorites
yes.
as well.
Oh, good. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, I hope you have moved your furniture, because you are about to hear from a woman who has certainly earned the title of Motown Diva. Would you please welcome Martha Reeves?
Yeah!
Thank you.
any opportunity to dress up. I love show business.
Right. Yeah. But you know what? There was almost a time when you almost left it, wasn't there?
Yeah, I thought about it.
Yeah.
Things look kind of bleak. My son was a year old. I have a 24-year-old son, and I have two grandbabies that I'm so proud of. They went to school yesterday.
Yeah!
Granny. Reading in your book here, you know, they said you started as a secretary, but to have you tell the story, you go, I wasn't a secretary. I just happened to be a singer who could type.
That's right. I was invited to Motown Records by William Stevenson, better known as Mickey. And when I arrived, he asked me, what was I doing there? I said, well, remember giving me a card last night? You said, come for an audition. He said, yeah, but you have to schedule auditions.
Yeah.
Right, Mary?
Right, that's right.
So he said, answer this phone. I'll be right back. He was gone 3 hours. In those 3 hours, I answered the phone. I had a neatly stacked pile of messages. I got musicians' money. I did all kinds of things. And I declared myself A&R secretary, although there was none.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And I heard when you left, it took three people to replace you.
From secretarial college, yes.
Yeah. That's how good she is.
I'm glad they couldn't sing.
Yeah.
That's right. And you had so many hits. Yes. I mean, truly Motown diva. Right?
Well, I love that. Mark Beagle, a friend of Mary Wilson's, gave me that title.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, when you use the word friend, let's talk about this healthy rival that happened in the 60s when all these groups are coming up and you're all striking it. I mean, you're all hitting it big.
Yeah.
Did you enjoy the competition? Did you go out and work a room and say, try to follow that?
Oh, yeah. No, we just made it hot for the next act.
Yeah.
Right.
Whoever started the show started the pace. And we all took turns starting. We all took turns opening, so we know what position we were in, and we played that position. It's almost like football or basketball or anything else.
Yeah, but you know what? I remember We the Supremes had that position for a long time, but being the no-hit Supremes.
Yeah.
And we had to start many a days. But one thing that I love about the rivalry that we had there, you'd stand behind stage, you'd look at everybody, and you'd say, okay, the temps will come off, and the next person said, okay, now I got to top that.
That's
a wonderful kind of friendly.
What a great era to be growing up in, have that kind of community spirit.
Isn't that nice how William Stevenson and Berry Gordy had the initiative to go around the city and find all of the best of the amateurs. We all competed on a local level in amateur shows.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And so we went and picked all and got the best of jazz musicians.
That's
the secret for the Motown sound. Mm-hmm. Jazz musicians, let us be heard.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, congratulations. Like the Temptations and like the Supremes, you were just inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Grandma is getting inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
They take me very lightly. I think they'll be more impressed when I take them to the Henry Ford Museum and show them the display there.
Yeah,
there's $1.3 million been put into a display at the Henry Ford Museum in Detroit.
Right.
It's a must-see for everybody.
But see,
a Motown display.
Yes.
Wow.
But they're honoring someone real. And I know this is a point of contention with you because there are groups out there that are billing themselves as... There is a group touring.
I'm so upset.
Tell a story.
I'm so upset. There's a Martha and the Vandellas touring on the West Coast.
But
then Carl Gardner, who is one of my dearest and oldest friends, is now in court with somebody who has a group of coasters, the Drift, coasting drifters,
yes.
And fake Marvelettes, and we're still alive, and I think it's a real insult, and something should be done about it. It should be illegal.
Yeah.
And so if you go to a show and you see some fake people, don't watch them. Ask for your money.
That's right.
I mean, give us some play. We've been here 35 years.
That's great.
Right.
Continue. We gotta take a break. Man, a little bit of music. We'll go. We'll be right back.
Yes.
Keep it going.
These Motown legends like before they were stars? Find out as we take a surprise trip down Motown memory lane next.
It's possible, mathematically possible, to have a reunion every day, but that's what we're going to do. We're going to have a reunion every day. We are back with legends. What an honor to be able to say that. Mary Wilson, Otis Williams, and Martha Reeves all together. What a
Oh, This is such a thrill for me.
Tell us about Charm School.
Yes, I was just going to mention that. Maxine Powell taught all of us, and we used to have such a great time. This was at Motown Records when we were still kind of struggling. You know, a lot of us didn't have hit records.
Right.
And what they did, just like in the days of Hollywood, they had a Charm School. They called it Artist Development. And we had the choreographer was Charlie Atkins, who did all the
still steps doing it, 80
still
years
doing
old.
It, right?
You're kidding?
The finishing touches.
Well, he did the choreography, and Mrs. Powell, that actually Martha and I know very well. I think we frequented her class more than the Temps did, right?
I consider myself cum laude graduate.
Oh, you didn't go to
Powell? No.
Well, stop right there, because we have a little surprise.
We've been doing some investigative reporting here.
Our correspondent, Chris McWatt, has done some investigating on his own and has uncovered some secrets from your Charm School past. Chris?
That's right. You don't try to run away now. I talked to Maxine yesterday. And I went back.
Oh,
I have the facts right here. She was my deep throat on this investigative project 2020. It was, she had lots of things. But she said you were excellent students. You all graduated from Charm School. Did a very good job.
I'm cum laude from the School of Charm.
There you go. Magna cum laude.
Yeah.
But she said early on you had a few little things you had to get out. So what I'm going to ask the audience. Now, which of our guests today, our Motown legends, did Maxine recommend the following? Buy a joke book and practice telling jokes to help you come out of your shell. Who do you think that was? Who do you think, stand up, who do you think that was?
Aretha Franklin.
No.
Otis? Now you think Otis may have to come out there? Well, I'll let you know that through exhaustive research, it was not Otis, it was Martha Reeves.
Whoa! That is not true.
That's what she said.
That is not true.
Okay.
Thank you, Ms. Powell. Thank you, darling. I was captain of my cheering team, and I was kind of tomboyish, so she had to teach me how to be ladylike, and that's about it. I tell my own jokes.
You had to calm down.
I'd move on if I were you.
Right on, program.
Move along to the next one. The other investigative research. Now, who? Well, I'm crossing on tough ground here, but who, Maxine told me one of our guests had to learn to use a microphone and kind of keep herself inside, like not, or the guest not really stick out, well, I can say it, I guess, it's his TV, but out too much. They were on the road and they saw you perform.
Out? I don't understand what you're saying.
That definitely leaves me out.
Tell it like it is.
They were, that you were sticking, you were grabbing the microphone and sticking your butt out a little too much. You were on the road performing the shake and sending a little bit of the wrong body language. What guest do you think that was? Stand up.
I was there.
You were there.
It's gotta be Otis. Wait a minute.
Otis?
No.
He said her. I'm not a her.
She didn't hear that.
Otis has always been smooth.
He's very smooth.
He's always been smooth.
So Maxine said.
Now, who had the booty problem? Who was it?
It wasn't me, per se, me. It was the Supremes. We were doing a song. We did the album Supreme Sings Sam Cooke, and we did Shake. And we were like doing like this shake. You know,
I remember that.
In England?
I remember that.
And so Mrs. Powell said, no, ladies, you don't do it like that. You must stand up and never protrude diarrhea. That's how she said. And so it was the Supremes.
Okay, well, one out of two
was
bad.
We were trying to get down like Martha and the Vandellas.
Hello.
Learning from each other. And finally, Maxine was talking about how she, though she didn't handle all the choreography, she was talking about how she talked the Temptations, how to figure how much space they needed on stage. And I have two volunteers, stand up. Now, gentlemen, stand right here. The clue that Maxine told me was to reach out your fingertips until you touch the next person. Now, tell me if I'm doing this right, Otis. Was it here or inside to find out how far away you should be from each other on stage?
Well, I have to say she's wrong.
The
reason I said that?
Yes.
We only work with Charlie Atkins and Lon Fontaine as far as the choreography.
What did he say? Did he say this far away?
And before that was Paul Williams.
Oh, okay. How did you determine how far away you were supposed to be?
Well, Charlie Atkins had his own method. So, Miss Brown only worked with the girls, never with the guys.
Okay.
Did any of you guys have two left feet?
She worked with Marvin Gaye.
She didn't work with the Temps.
She worked with Marvin Gaye.
Because you guys cut classes.
No. Charlie Atkins didn't let us do that.
Did any of you have like two left feet? I mean, was anybody wasn't coordinated?
You know what? In our group, we did. Every time we would have one spot, it was Florence, and then when Florence was replaced by Cindy, they all kind of moved in a kind of awkward way. There's always somebody who.
Oh,
yeah.
And Otis, you say you
were... I was stiff as a box of Argo Star.
But you overcame that, babe, because you were up there.
Rosalind Holmes, Ashford, is actually left-handed, so she had to learn to work on the opposite side of the stage and use her right hand as opposed to what she's used to using as her left. So, yeah.
We got to take a little break here. We're going to take back more questions from the audience. In fact, there was one that someone here asked, how did the inspiration for My Girl come up?
come about. I want to know if there was a girl. Take a break. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
All right. Yeah.
Sitting with you, and we're kind of just like quietly humming along, you know, like not to bother, but to be in the circle is just so cool.
I mean, I try to sing, and people like cry and stuff when I sing, but it's good that you guys are here making me.
We spoke during the break. Martha's agreed to it. If you guys want to do it, we'll meet again same time next year, right?
Yes.
Here.
Yes.
Huh?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
We had a question from the audience.
Where is she? A young lady wanted to know about my girl.
This is Linda Stone. Linda, what was the question that you had?
It was actually for Otis. Otis, yes. I kind of have a 3-in-1 question. Okay. I wanted to know where your inspiration for the song My Girl came from. Was she your girl? If so, who was she?
Well, actually, we have to credit Smokey Robinson and Ronnie White.
Right. So it could be Claudette Robinson.
Had to be at that time.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, so Smokey and Ronnie.
Claudette is Smokey's wife?
Wife, yes. At that time.
Okay.
So Claudette is the My Girl.
She's
yes.
The My Girl.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. Is it Linda?
Linda Loveland.
Inspiration, huh?
My question is for Martha.
Hi.
Martha, hi. Who inspired you to become a singer?
Lena Horne.
Wow.
By way of Dinah Washington.
Wow.
And my father, Elijah, sang and played guitar, so they inspired me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Now, how about you? Did you sing when you were very, very young as well, Mary?
My mom said when I was born, I started singing. When the doctor spanked me, I started singing. But, I mean, you know, I used to sing if I would open the refrigerator, you know, if I sang all the time.
So Mane, saw the light come on,
yeah,
the refrigerator,
right?
that was your spotlight.
I know people say, you know, they say that all the time as a joke, but I really, from the time I can remember when I was like 3, I was always singing. I did it just naturally. Mm-hmm. I never wanted to be a singer. I never thought about being a singer. It's just that's something I did.
It was your calling.
What I wanted to do was to be an actress. I mean, when I was little, I watched all the you know, those musicals and things. Sure. That's what I wanted to do.
Well, we weren't candy at the age of 3. I was 3, my brothers were older. So I knew I was going to be a singer at 3 in my grandfather's church. So we started singing gospel first.
Right.
That'll
right.
stay with you,
yeah,
won't it?
Sure will.
Oh, yeah. I want to get this to this question. Where is Erica? Chris?
Right here.
Okay.
This question is for Otis.
Oh, man. Otis, this one's for you, right?
Uh-oh.
Okay.
We have a tape of your London concert, and there's a part where you sing My Girl, and then you have people come up from the audience, mm-hmm. and you ask them to wiggle their hips.
That's right.
So I was wondering if today you could wiggle out your hips for us here today.
No, I don't wiggle.
Because you always have the women wiggle.
And I believe,
hips.
If I'm not mistaken, right. you have an exercise video coming out where you do that. And the pounds just roll off.
Roll off.
That's right. We've got to take a commercial break. We come back with a little more fun. We're going to close the show, a little music, a little dancing. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
All of you, and thanks to the musicians today.
That keep
great.
The sound
Thank
alive.
You.
Thank you, guys.
Whoa!
And producers and the writers.
That's
you know,
right.
Colin Dozier-Holland,
Morgan
Robinson.
Yeah. The Motown Legends Tour continues. Mary Wilson tonight and tomorrow at the Universal Amphitheater
four
right
tops.
Here in Los Angeles and the Four Tops.
That's
Plus,
right.
The Sound of Young America, Motown the Year-by-Year series is available on 6 CDs.
And let me just tell you, I'm taking that home.
There you go. And if you don't mind, a quick plug for us tomorrow. The big shows continue. An international talk show exclusive, Princess Di's former housekeeper. The woman that lived with her for 8 years is on our show. She gives us the exclusive tomorrow right here. Officially, we want to thank Mary Wilson, Otis,
Don't leave me. understand there.